Hey guys, Robert Ian Bonnick, RIB, inspirational speaker, inspirational coach, and author of Soul Survivor. Now, today we're going to talk about defining moments, okay? So now, defining moments, what do I mean by defining moment? Defining moment is a moment in your past, right? A moment in your life where you outperformed yourself. A moment in your life where you may be facing a wall and you overcame it. A moment in life that in which you showed up for yourself, right? The leader came out. A person you could rely upon, a person you could trust, right? A person that you love, a person that maybe against the odds came out on top, right? So last night I watched a Netflix original called The Last Dance about the Chicago Bulls, which are obviously about Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls. And like, it just stirred something within me, right? It stirred a reminder for me personally, you know, because growing up into children's homes from 6 months to age of 18 in London, I went through many different parts of my life, very many defining moments, because, you know, I was, you know, for a lot of that time, not a lot, some of that time, I was an angry kid, but the anger was wrapped up in being shy, but I was angry, right? So I remember one of my first defining moments was when I was playing rugby at school, and I realized that I could legitimately put all my hurt, pain, and fear into tackling people, right? And you know, and I was competitive, right? But I didn't know it. But then I kind of really embraced it. So one defining moment was for me one day was that, you know, when I was playing rugby and this guy pissed me off for some reason. Maybe it was something racially motivated, I don't know, but something that just really pissed me off. And what I did next, you know, I lined this guy up, I squared him up, and I tackled this guy with all of my might. I think I actually went in with my head as opposed to my shoulder. And like this guy, he didn't get up, right? He was writhing in pain. I was in pain, right? But he was writhing in pain. I got up first, I was a bit dizzy. This was like before the days of being concussed and all the rest of that. And you know, the defining moment for me was that, you know, I realized, you know, that I could transmute my energy of hurt, pain, and fear, right, into something else. I could evacuate that feeling into something else. So that was important for me, you know, to realize that hey, you know, like I have this ability, you know, to use my pain in that type of way. So, you know, what that started off was, was a string of events, which I'll get into in a minute. But then, you know, another defining moment for me came later on, right? Now, this is the juxtaposition of the one I've just told you. So this one was a racially motivated attack on me and a friend. And it was physical, it was very physical. It's in my book, Soul Survivor, How an Abandoned Child Came From, or so went from nothing to everything, right? And I go into some great detail in that. But what I got from this was an understanding that, you know, that I was pissed off, I was upset, but it was an understanding that, you know, that I need to find ways to bring us as a race of different backgrounds, races, ideologies, and so on. I need to find a way to bring us together, not tear us apart, right? And that was a defining moment for me because, you know, like I said, I wanted revenge, really. That's what I really wanted. But then I saw, you know, like how that was, in a way, that was futile. Because that was just perpetuating the cycle of the Hundred Years' War, you know, a war that went on for 100 years, right? It's parents passing it on to their kids, you know, and passing that hatred down the generations in your family and through your friendships, relationships, and so on. It just breeds more and more of the same, right? So I saw all of this in the blink of an eye and thought, I don't want to be part of that problem, I want to be part of the solution. So that second defining moment, there was more in my life than that one that we brought up today, gave me, you know, the juxtaposition of the first, right? So, you know, so why is this important? You know, like, why is it important to really embrace your defining moments? Why is it important to go back in your life and look at the time or look at the times where, you know, something happened to you, you know, and what happened out of it was that you were able to show up for yourself. You were able to realize something so important and crucial that it changed the course of your life, right? So think back, you know, even if you have to pause this now, think back over, you know, what periods of time you went through and you had to really rethink the way that you're doing things. That through one act, one instance, one moment, one second, right, that it changed the course of how you thought. Now why is that why is that important? You know, because, you know, right now for me, as I mentioned before, through watching this this Netflix original last night, the Last Dance, there's a few episodes there, and I watched too many. And I'm still not done. There's more episodes to come, you know. But like again, it got me back in touch with this kid at school. You know, at school, you know, I was playing football. You know, against, you know, against, it felt like it was me versus the world, right? It was me. Remember when you're at school, you're very young, I don't know, maybe 6, 10, that type of age. And it was me versus these two other kids, Martin and Martin, from memory. And I would choose a team and they would choose a team. But what it would be me basically taking on the onus of winning that game. And I would go, I would be slide tackling on concrete. You know, like my legs would be scratched up, and they're still scratched up now. I would do anything and everything in my power to win, right? And that was my approach, right? And you know, moving forward to playing basketball for England, it was like that again. I did everything I could. I outworked, outperformed. You know, I had it on my brain: basketball. You know, training, shooting, jumping, dribbling. Right, I would do it after school, I'd do it before school, I'd do it at school lunchtimes, and it worked. I got into the England under 15 basketball team, right? And that was not a defining moment for me, because what I realized then was that, like, you know, if I could do this, if I could get into the England basketball team, I could do anything. If I could apply myself like that, I could become anything, right? And now the interesting part is that at some point, you know, I self-sabotaged, right? At some point, I began to start to limit myself, limit my ability, right? And my ability. Sorry, there's a dustbin truck at the end over here. We're in Bali. There's a dustbin truck and it kind of it threw me. I'm wondering if they're going to come down here, if they want to come down here to collect the rubbish, which they don't. So we can carry on, right? So I began to doubt myself, right? And watching this Michael Jordan, well, the Chicago Bulls, The Last Dance last night, it just kind of reminded me, of that person that I am, what I have inside of me, right? And to a certain extent, with that other defining moment I mentioned about, you know, that racist attack, and the next day realizing that I had a mission, and my mission was to unite people. Somewhere in that mission, I believe that I allowed myself, you know, to self-sabotage myself. I allowed myself, you know, to start to gently put that energy down, right? Because it stood out, you know? It was, you know, I became, you know, what I would call, you know, like a spiritual person, you know, as well. And I think that I allowed myself to start self-limiting, right? And anger, I don't show anger, you know, that much. And I like to think it's because I'm some kind of like evolved being, right? Maybe I am. But the thing is, though, is that anger is an energy, it's an emotion, which I know, as I did back then, you know, I need to transmute that energy, right? Transmute that energy from one form to another, right? And so all of these things, you know, came back at me last night when I was watching this this is the Last Dance series on Netflix, and I got a really strong feeling that this is another defining moment for me. You know, I'm 50 years of age, and I feel like my life has been amazing. I've done some incredible things, but I've also checked out on a couple of things as well, right? I've checked out. So now it's time for me to reconnect with that energy. And again, so this is where we're going with this defining moment, is that, you know, as I did with the rugby, I transmitted the energy from one to the other. So now it's time for me to get back in that flow of energy again, right? To acknowledge it, accept it, and use it, right? So to use that energy, so how do you use it? So one example, one way of using it is to, you know, is to go back to a time when you really excelled, a time when you overcame, you know, a big challenge for you. You overcame it, right? And now a way to use it is to tap back into those times and those moments where you overcame something important for you, and then project that forward into the challenge or war that you're facing now. Because one thing which I've, you know, which I've learned, I've understood, is that life is supporting you, right? Through challenge, but that's life giving you an opportunity to step up. That's life giving you an opportunity to step up and overcome that challenge, to step into the person that you were born to be, right? Which is unlimited and is, you know, it's unparalleled. You know, we have all the power of the universe at our disposal, guys, right? But it's about us choosing to acknowledge, accept, and overcome. Acknowledge, accept, and overcome, right? So with me, when I coach people, I use a system that I created called Dream, Rise, and Realize, right? So dream, we start with a dream. What is it you want to achieve, right? Now, rising is about, what I'm talking about now, is rising above all challenges, right? Rise above all challenges. And then to realize is to achieve your dream. All right, so guys, I hope there's some value in there for you. My intention is for it to have some value for you, whoever's watching this. So look, I'll be back doing these longer forms, probably on YouTube and Facebook and so on. So feel free to tune into my YouTube channel. I'll put the link in below. I've just started this channel, or it feels like I just have. I need to get to 100 subscribers very quickly. So please support me, pass it on, follow me, so I can get to that first 100 subscribers. And look, I'll even give away some coaching sessions as well. So look, hit me up, right? Tell me that, Rob, I've just followed you, right, on my social media. And let's connect for a coaching call if you feel that it will be of value to you. Lots of love, guys. Thanks for tuning in. And I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.